Oh, hello, coronavirus pilgrims. I've come to my studio, as I call it, it's just a bedroom really, to make a little icon for the inauguration of the straw chapel of the Annunciation, which I hope will happen tomorrow. So I'm turning aside from my recent work on this robin, which still isn't finished. It's kind of sat there for over a month now. Anyway, poor little robin's going to get ignored. Now, pictures of the Annunciation sometimes look like this, but I'm intending something more simple and more abstract. So I've got this decent bit of wood that I'm going to do my painting on, which will emerge before your very eyes. So the first thing I want to do is sort of darken this a little bit. So I've got some cheap burnt umber. Just spread this out, get it darkened up, make a bit of a background. You know, it's difficult holding the camera and spreading this stuff. So come back in a moment and see how it's worked out. So there we are, very interesting. Well, it'll become more interesting. Well, it was flying too slow, so I just ought to do this. In the writing of icons, gold is used often to symbolise heaven. So I've got this paint here. It's become a bit of a mixed media composition, this. Anyway, I'm going to use this shiny gold paint along the top to indicate the sky and heaven. So we'll see how this goes. I might need to stop filming because it might be impossible to do it with one hand. And spread it out a bit. It was not going to be fine art. So this stuff works best if you just let it kind of flow around. So once I've got spread more or less to where I want, I'm going to let it do its thing. I think it will be tilting up, so we'll come back to that in a while, see how it's worked out. A few minutes later, it's doing its thing. I'm going to let the drips drip and then apply a bit of warmth and dry it off. That makes some interesting shapes. Heaven penetrating earth or something like that. Right, I have an idea based on the well-worn spirit of making things up as I go along. So we've got some nice drips coming down here. I think I'd just quite like to sort of smear them down so they're not drips, but we still get that downward movement. That's the plan anyway. So I've got some rough paper here and I'm going to pick this up, turn it onto the paper and sort of pull it across so we get like a smear effect. This is a one-shot thing, so we'll see how it goes. I want to do it carefully so I won't be able to film it because I want to use both hands. So we'll see very shortly what happens. Well, that's what happened to the paper. And that's what's happened to the painting. So, exactly. What is there possibly to say about this? Anyway, it's not too bad. I'm sure we can work with this. There you are, I've roughed it up a bit and instantly added centuries to its look. Now this gold paint is resin based, so I've applied a bit of heat to it, but I think it's just going to take a little time. So what can we do? I'll just have to go and have a cup of coffee.
Vicarosaurus, like a normal vicar, but more awesome. Or more dinosaur. Anyway, nearly finished my coffee.
Time to try and paint some kind of a depiction of Mary. So I've been experimenting with a few possibilities. We'll see how this goes. It's not meant to be a Leonardo. It's meant to be more of an abstract. This is going to be a bit tricky holding the camera, but here we go. So I think I want her about here. And something like this. Yeah, I can see this water-based paint. It's not going to like being on this resin until it's properly dry. So be it. Transparent effect, which is of some interest. Anyway, it's not meant to be perfect figure form, but it's enough. Time for the angel. Now I have in my mind that I want to have this figure kneeling somewhat or bowing. So I want the head of the angel to be something like that. Ghostly. Knee or something coming out here. In the Bible, angels aren't always depicted or written about as having wings. Sometimes the heavenly host is spoken of in those terms, but not always. When they turn up as messengers in various stories, having wings is a bit of an irrelevance. They're just there to pass on the message. I don't know whether this is going to work, but it's an abstraction. You can get away with anything.
Yeah. I'm going to give this one some wings because that's often. So I had in mind that it could come out like this. Splaying the wings somewhat. And then maybe on this side, slightly collapsed wing. Well, I had to put down the camera. So this is how it's ended up at the moment. I've put a halo around, and similarly for the figure of Mary, and composition so far is like that. I don't add too much more to this, but I've got an idea. I want to add a line between the angel and Mary, and got some nice vermilion I think I'll do that in. This is this little bit of wood is just a guide. So I'm going to have to hold it all together while I do it, so I can't film as well. There we are, nice little red line between the angel and Mary. And to go with the times, I want to put yeah, that's a bit clearer. 8.2 for 2 meters. Why not? It is finished. Don't really want to do too much. I don't want to make it too fiddly. So we have the red line between the angel and Mary, and 2 signifying 2 meters. And I've put in a title, which is quite common in icons. Often it's written in Greek in the style of such things, and I've written it in English. Annunciation, and the year 2020. So there we are. I'll let that dry off, and I hope to put it in the chapel of the Annunciation, made of bales of straw, at the Vicarage.